The road to WrestleMania has officially begun! Welcome to Monday Night Raw! And we are kicking things off with the world's heavyweight champion, the Kingslayer, is here in San Antonio to burn it down! Hello everybody, I'm Kurt Rodriguez, this is Monday Night Raw, wait, what? It's Dean Ambrose! What the hell? Dean Ambrose! Dean Ambrose is on top of Seth Rollins! What is going on here? We saw Dean Ambrose return at the Royal Rumble. He was in the Royal Rumble match. He did not win. And now Dean Ambrose is here. And he's attacking his former best friend. They were best friends. And Dean Ambrose is all over Seth Rollins. Dean Ambrose all over the world's heavyweight champion. A malicious attack, and now he's holding the world's heavyweight championship in his hands. What the hell is Dean Ambrose thinking here? Dean Ambrose laying out his best friend. Oh my god, what is this? And Rollins now fighting back. Absolutely incredible, ladies and gentlemen. I can't understand why Dean would be doing this. Right before Dean got injured, they were tag team champions. And now Ambrose all over Rollins. Oh, hitting him across the head with a championship. Rollins is doing his best to try to fight against Dean Ambrose here. And Ambrose trying to suplex Dean, but Dean Ambrose gets taken down by Rollins, the world's heavyweight champion, finally fighting back. An absolutely incomprehensible attack here by Dean Ambrose. He just came back. We were excited to have him here on Monday Night Raw, to have him back here on Monday night. And what a return Dean has made. After failing to win the Royal Rumble, Dean Ambrose has acquired a target in the world's champion. Oh no, Ambrose going! Ambrose after the knee of Rollins. Remember, that's a surgically repaired knee from Seth Rollins, and now Rollins is down. Oh my god, what is Dean doing here? What the hell is Dean thinking here? Oh, and Dean sending Rollins off the stage. And now right in front of our table, Dean Ambrose taunting Rollins. My goodness. 30 Deans on the concrete. We're back live on Monday Night Raw. Moment. Yeah. Oh no, come on, and this is just gonna keep going, isn't it? Ladies and gentlemen, moments ago, Dean Ambrose made his return to Monday Night Raw by attacking the world's heavyweight champion, Seth Rollins. And now, Dean Ambrose has found Seth Rollins backstage, and the fight has continued. Seth Rollins trying to retaliate, sending Ambrose against the concrete walls here at the AT&T Center in San Antonio. Over and over again, Rollins tossing Ambrose around like a rag doll. Whatever there was to this friendship died on this stage a couple of minutes ago when Ambrose attacked Rollins. And now it's Ambrose running away from Rollins. Look at this. Maybe it was not a good idea to attack your former best friend. Ambrose running away from Rollins into the parking lot area. We're seeing a split screen view here. Ambrose perhaps waiting for Rollins. Yes, he is. Hit him across the head with a steel chair. The merciless Dean Ambrose hitting Seth Rollins over and over again with a steel chair. I cannot believe what I am watching here. These two used to be tag team champions together, and Dean Ambrose, as he returns from injury, has done nothing but torture Rollins during these past few minutes for a Monday Night Raw. Steel chair shot after steel chair shot in the backstage area. Somebody needs to stop this lunatic Ambrose. Somebody needs to stop him. Oh no, not again, not again, and that's another dirty deed. We're back live on Monday Night Raw. These happened moments ago. The World's Heavyweight Champion Seth Rollins was making his way out here. He was attacked by his former best friend, Dean Ambrose. Ambrose would lay him out on top of the stage. The World's Heavyweight Champion was then dragged down into the concrete area in front of our announce table. And then Ambrose would hit his finisher. The dirty deeds on Rollins right in front of our announce table in the concrete. That's not all, because this fight would continue in the backstage area. Backstage, Ambrose hitting Rollins over and over again with a steel chair. Mercilessly hitting Rollins with many, many chair shots. And this would lead to another dirty deeds on the concrete. During the commercial break, Seth Rollins asked General Manager Kurt Angle, bet him to get him a match against Dean Ambrose, and he will get his wish, with the caveat that the World Heavyweight Championship will be on the line. This one will be good, ladies and gentlemen. Saturday, February 16 at Fastlane, Dean Ambrose challenges Seth Rollins for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship, live right here on The Space. Well, speaking of Fastlane, this next match has big implications towards Fastlane.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, accompanied by Sami Zayn from Maryville, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 266 pounds, Kevin Owens.
Well, Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn are making their way out here. It was back in December at the New Year's special, when Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn scored their first victory against the Revival. And now, Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn are vying to become Raw Tag Team Champions. If Kevin Owens can defeat Dash Wilder tonight here on Monday Night Raw, Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn will get an opportunity at the Raw Tag Team Championships on Saturday, February 16 at Fastlane. But of course, that is easier said than done. The tough guys do not want the competition, and they will put up a fight.
And his opponent, accompanied by Scott Thompson, representing the Revivalers from Kill Hill, North Carolina, weighing in at 223 pounds, one half of the Raw Tag Team Champion, Dash Wilder.
Like I said, Dash Wilder tonight stepping into singles competition, and that's perhaps the roadblock for both of these teams. Of course, they are not competing tag team action tonight. Both of them consider themselves to be tag team specialists. Tonight is a singles match. And if Dash Wilder can beat former Universal Champion Kevin Owens in a singles match tonight, then the dreams of Sami Zayn and Kevin Owens will be shattered. Of course, we're on the road to WrestleMania. It's all about the championships. A championship title almost guarantees that you will be a part of the WrestleMania card in some way, shape, or form. Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn are being smart here. They win the Raw Tag Team Championships. They can get on the WrestleMania card. Of course, the Revival has to be very wary of Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn. Owens and Zayn have been rising through the ranks as tag teams here on Raw. Shoulders down, where's the official? Shoulders down here by Owens to the kick out. Owens and Zayn, like I said, have been rising through the ranks in tag team competition here on Monday Night Raw, earning a victory against the Revival, the Raw Tag Team Champions, back on our New Year's Eve special. And that's what brought him to the dance here, as Kevin Owens now tosses Dash Wilder to the outside of the ring. Kevin Owens may have some bad intentions here. Look at this. Owens over the third rope into ringside. Dash Wilder catches him. And that's the agility of a man like Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens has basically done it all here in WWE. Oh no, the clothesline is Scott Dawson! Getting a little taste of Owens here. It's a multiple time champion here in the WWE. Meanwhile, the Revival are two-time Raw Tag Team Champions. They defeated the Authors of Pain back at Bendis in December to win those tag team championships. And of course, that could have been a super kick. Dash Wilder, very smart looking. Wilder carrying the weight of Owens. That's not easy, but Owens fights back with elbows to the face. And there's the super kick by Owens. Off the super kick, shoulders down. Is it enough? And a kick out by Wilder. Owens now hooks him in. Brings him back down. Kevin Owens may have some bad intentions here, and seems like Scott Dawson is complaining about something to the official. Here's Owens. Bump up, power bomb connects. Could this be the ticket? Oh, come on, Scott Dawson. Scott Dawson distracting the official. And Kevin Owens has had enough of Scott Dawson. Shoulders down on Wilder. Is it enough? But Wilder gets the shoulder up. Too much time in between cover. And now Owens to the top rope, going for a frog splash. But Wilder gets the knees up. Wilder now sending Owens to the outside of the ring. And it seems like the official has ejected Scott Dawson from ringside due to his interference earlier in the match. Very smart move by the official here, removing Scott Dawson from ringside, but now the Revival is outnumbered. Sami Zayn is still in the other corner. And now Dash Wilder has to do this on his own here tonight. Doesn't look very good for him. The Revival already losing a match against Owens and Zayn back in December. The New Year seems spectacular, and you can't afford to have another loss. And there's a super kick by Owens. Shoulders down in the ropes. Allow Wilder to continue. Wilder now sent into the corner. The shadow of the WrestleMania sign. Sent shoulder first into the turnbuckle post. And Owens cannonball against Wilder. Wilder could be in trouble. Are Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn punching their ticket to Fastlane? Here we go, look out. Bump up, powerbomb connects. Shoulders down, hook and leg, is it enough to get to Fastlane? Got him, got him, got him. Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn are headed to Fastlane. An imposing victory by Kevin Owens, earning him and his tag team partner Sami Zayn a match against the Revival for the Raw Tag Team titles. And you can see the clear disappointment in the face of Dash Wilder as he heads to the back. It is now official at Fastlane. The Raw Tag Team Championships will be on the line. Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn will challenge the Revival Saturday, February 16, live right here on the space. This ought to be good. Who's headed to WrestleMania with the Raw Tag Team titles? And we are back live on Monday Night Raw. Here comes the winner of the 2019 Royal Rumble match. It was at the Royal Rumble where Finn Balor last eliminated Aleister Black to punch his ticket to the Meadowlands, to WrestleMania. He will be fighting for either the WWE Championship or the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. Finn Balor said that you have to keep his eyes peeled on social media, which is where he will announce who he's facing at WrestleMania when he makes the decision. When we talk about the highs, and we also have to talk about the lows, because it was at the Royal Rumble, the night where Finn Balor won the Royal Rumble match and advanced to WrestleMania. At the beginning of the night, Royal Rumble, Finn Balor lost the Intercontinental Championship against Drew McIntyre. Drew McIntyre defeated the Demon King to take the Intercontinental Championship from him. And I remember Finn Balor talking about wanting to go to WrestleMania as double champion, the Intercontinental, and fighting for the World Heavyweight Championship or the WWE Championship. Tonight, Finn Balor gets the opportunity to fulfill that fantasy, because he gets his rematch for the Intercontinental Championship against Drew McIntyre. Balor Club is in full effect here tonight at the sold-out AT&T Center in San Antonio. San Antonio has seen their fair shares of Royal Rumbles, including the one in the Alamo Dome in 2017. Tonight they're seeing the post-Royal Rumble Monday Night Raw featuring, of course, the 2019 Royal Rumble Bash winner, Finn Balor. It was after the Royal Rumble match when Finn Balor was declared the winner that Drew McIntyre posted a picture of himself with his newly acquired Intercontinental Championship asking, is he really a winner though? Of course, McIntyre can now say that he played spoiler to Balor's night, because in the first match of the evening he took that Intercontinental Championship from the Demon King, and that asterisk will always be there right next to Balor's Royal Rumble win. Question is, can Drew McIntyre capitalize on the momentum of winning the Intercontinental Championship to kick off the road to WrestleMania? Or will Drew McIntyre fall to the Demon King and now future WrestleMania headliner, Finn Balor?
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the Intercontinental Championship. Introducing the challenger from Bray, weighing in at 190 pounds, Finn Balor! Introducing the champion from Ayr, Scotland, weighing in at 254 pounds, he is the Intercontinental Champion, Drew McIntyre.
Intercontinental Championship on the line. This is Drew McIntyre's first defense of the Intercontinental Championship since winning that championship at the Royal Rumble. Balor, of course, won that championship twice back in 2018. Will he be able to score it for a third time in 2019? And there's the bell. Here we go. Intercontinental title for grabs. Front on able tie up between McIntyre and Balor. This is our first of two championship matches tonight, as Sasha Banks will also be receiving her rematch for the Raw Women's Championship later tonight in our main event. Banks goes 1-on-1 against Rousey. McIntyre now sending Balor into the corner. Nice reversal by Balor. Kick to the head of McIntyre, takes him down, and a kick to the back with McIntyre propping himself back up. Reversal here by Balor. Balor missing wildly with that drop kick. McIntyre taking the advantage here. McIntyre hooks Balor in and drops him. Oh my God, it's Bray Wyatt. Oh no. What? What is happening? Bray Wyatt is here. Bray Wyatt with a Sister Abigail. Wyatt, Sister Abigail on McIntyre. McIntyre out of the ring now. And Wyatt turns his attention to Balor. Wyatt turns his attention to Finn Balor. And Finn gets taken down with a Sister Abigail as well. Oh no, no. Come on, Bray, not another one. Not another one. Another Sister Abigail. Two in a row. Bray Wyatt sets his sights on the winner of the Royal Rumble, Finn Balor. The Eater of Worlds is back on Raw.
Balor, the buzzer.
And WrestleMania may be just around the corner, but Fastlane comes first, and we would like to send a special thank you to State Champs for Mine is Cold. The official theme is available on the band's new album, Living Proof, which you can stream on Apple Music and Spotify. And we already have a big card set up for Fastlane, including the Raw Tag Team Championships on the line. Kevin Owens, Sami Zayn will challenge the Revival for the Raw Tag Team titles. Will KO and Sammy begin their year with a bam by winning the Raw Tag Team titles? We'll find out live Saturday, February 16th. And of course, this has been added. After a few minutes ago, we saw Bray Wyatt lay out Finn Balor with two Sister Abigails. The Eater of Worlds will now take on the Demon King. Bray Wyatt goes one-on-one against Finn Balor. Saturday, February 16th at Fastlane. And of course, the big main event after everything we saw earlier tonight here on Monday Night Raw, Dean Ambrose will get Seth Rollins one-on-one with the World Heavyweight Championship on the line. The ultimate roadblock on the road to WrestleMania. World title wrap Saturday, February 16th at Fastlane. Not only is it main event time, but it's also boss time here in San Antonio. It was at the Royal Rumble where Sasha Banks lost her Raw Women's Championship against the baddest woman on the planet, Rowdy Ronda Rousey. Of course, Sasha Banks won that Raw Women's Championship by cashing in Money in the Bank on her best friend Bayley and cheating to retain that title, but it seems like at the Royal Rumble, she met her match. Sasha is, of course, hiding behind the fact that Ronda Rousey cannot get Sasha Banks to tap out. Instead, she has to pin her. Tonight, of course, the rematch for the Raw Women's Championship. And here comes our new champion, the baddest woman on the planet, Rowdy Ronda Rousey. You know, Rowdy Ronda Rousey came to WWE a year ago to the date. And it was back at the Royal Rumble when she won the Raw Women's Championship for the first time. Now this is her first title defense as we kick off the road to WrestleMania. with high stakes. Ronda Rousey got through Sasha Banks at the Royal Rumble, and it was not easy effort. As mentioned before, Rousey could not get Banks to tap out to the armbar. Banks would keep breaking it.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the Raw Women's Championship. Introducing the challenger from Boston, Massachusetts, Sasha Banks. Introducing the champion from Venice Beach, California, the Raw Women's Champion, the baddest woman on the planet, Rowdy Ronda Rousey.
Big Five feeling San Antonio tonight as they're getting a rematch at the Raw Women's Championship. Rowdy Ronda Rousey and Sasha Banks. What a match this is gonna be, everybody. As the ref makes this one official here tonight. Title already with the new side plates for Rowdy Ronda Rousey. Here we go. Rousey locking in Banks with a knee to the head. The legit boss. And now Banks with a suplex over Rousey. Let's keep it back there. Shoulders down to Banks. Shoulders down to Mack. Raw Women's Championship on the line. And a kick out. Banks now sent into the ropes. Banks fights back. Rousey fights back with a kick to the plexus. Rousey now. Hooks her in. Powerbomb on Banks. What? It's Bayley. Bayley's theme song is playing here tonight. We can't see her. Don't exactly know where Bayley is. Oh my god, Bayley! Bayley to Bayley! To Ronda Rousey! Bayley to Bayley to Ronda Rousey! And now Bayley! With a Bayley to Bayley to Sasha Banks! What the hell is this? Well, I think this is called payback, everybody. Here's Bayley hitting the Bayley to Bayley to Ronda Rousey and then setting her eyes on Sasha Banks. Remember, Sasha betrayed her to get her hands on the Raw Women's Championship. And I think Bayley has not forgotten about that. I think Bayley wants a shot at that Raw Women's title. Bayley was cheated out of that championship twice, and now in the shadow of the WrestleMania sign, Bayley is back in contention. Think of the greatness tonight.